Here's my process for editing photos like these dark, moody tone photos that have minimal color to them, but the ones that are there pop. I'll be going over my process for editing these types of photos in Lightroom in this video, but these principles will work in almost any pro-level photo editor. But if you've never edited photos like this, where do you start? Well, before we get into the editing suite, there are three quick but very important tips for setting up your photo shoot for success that will make the whole process a lot easier for you from start to finish. Tip one is shoot raw. We want to make sure we're shooting raw so that we have more color data in our photos than just the 8-bit color information that's typically found in your average JPEG photos. So if your camera is set to JPEG, you want to change that over to raw. This gives us a lot of flexibility when we're going to be doing heavy color grading in post, which we're going to be doing in this one. Tip number two, use your histogram. Shoot in a way that ensures that you're not clipping your darkest tones and that you're not clipping your white highlights in the photo. Your histogram is the best way to do this in the field. If you want to learn how to read your histogram, you should watch my video on that. I'm going to throw it up in the corner right now in one of those links and maybe the thumbnail as well. It's also linked down in the description. Tip number three is expose to the left. When I go into a shoot and I know that I want my edit to be dark and moody, I will intentionally set my camera so that I am exposing towards the dark side of the histogram on purpose. I want my darks to be as close to clipping as possible, and I want my midtones actually shifted over a little bit. On the opposite end, as long as my whites and highlights aren't blown out, I don't really care what's happening there. And before we move into Lightroom, please leave me a like on this video if you found it helpful, and also let me know how your photos came out using this method in the comments below. I'm genuinely interested in how my tutorials might help people.
All right, so we're in Lightroom CC right now, and this workflow will work in Lightroom CC, Lightroom Classic, or pretty much any other photo editing software that has similar features. And for this video, I'm also gonna assume that you're editing more than just one photo in a series of photos. So step number four will be covering how to continue working on in that series. Here's a few images that we have from an engagement shoot that we did recently. And we're gonna go through and edit them like this client wants. They want those dark, moody photos. This is an overcast day in winter. And they're like, we really wanna lean into that. This is a good starting one. Because I already started to do a few basic edits here, knowing that what I want the final to look like. The first thing I do is I come down to my color, and I come down and I just desaturate the entire image. This part is editing for tonality. So you can see right now, everything is exposed to the left, like I said, which is fine because I want to retain a lot of the richness in those values. But as you can see, none of my blacks are actually clipped. They get as close to the end of the histogram as possible without clipping. So I want this photo to be dark and moody, and because we set up the camera correctly, and I already have my darks and midtones pressed up towards the far left side of the histogram, I'm already in a good spot, but you may wanna push your histograms over. So like, let's say your histogram looks a little bit more like this, and you're a little bit, you know, more evenly spread out, you're gonna wanna push it somewhere over so that, you know, you're on the left side. And all that does is it just shifts a lot of our values to be in the darks and midtones. So I actually like it as shot in terms of exposure. And then I bring my whites and my highlights up. And so I want to bring my whites up to the edge, and you can see there's a little spike there. So let's turn this on to see if we're clipping anywhere. And as long as I'm not clipping on the highlights of my subject here, I am happy with that. So you can see some of those lights are a little bit clipped. I'm not concerned really. And let's bring some of the highlights up as well. And we don't wanna clip. And that's just gonna create just a little bit more contrast. We're missing that like upper middle third in the histogram there. And what I'm really paying attention for is the highlights in their teeth and their skin. Because if I blow out a light here, that's not a big deal because it's light. It's going to be the brightest thing in our image. But people's skin, we can't really recover that data if it gets clipped. And it just looked really unprofessional. And so what I'm going to do here is this looks pretty good. What happens if I shift some of these shadows around? I like that at like a -8 there. What about my blacks? Yeah, there we go. Blacks are pretty close to clipping in important areas, so I'm gonna dial them back a little bit. And it kind of looks like as shot is good, right? We're close to clipping in like minor details here in the darkest darks, but that's not a big deal to me. Then finally for effects, what I'm going to do is add a bit of clarity and knock down the texture just a little bit. There we go. We're getting a little bit more separation there in our details. And so I'm happy with that. So step number two is where we go in and look at specific color. So what I'm going to do is add my saturation back. The white balance looks just a tiny bit off to me. That looks a little bit more like what I remember it being in person. So from here, we're going to choose our color palette. And this is where you get a little bit more specific and you need to kind of make some decisions for your own specific photo. We have to choose what's the focus of our composition here. And for us, it's this couple. And so their skin, their outfits, those are the things that I am primarily most concerned with. And so if we look at that, their outfits have a lot of brown tone and their skin has a lot of brown tone. And her dress is this dark greenish, almost emerald color, which means it's going to probably be more in the aquas than it is necessarily the green. We want to like take note of that. So it's really, you know, that kind of aqua tone, orange for our skin tones, a little bit of red in like the lips. First thing I want to do is I want to bring the saturation down in all of the colors we've identified that are not important to us. And as you can see, it's not doing too much to our image because there's not a lot of those colors present. And even if I desaturate the greens, it's not doing much to her dress. So we've identified that aqua tone as something that we want to pull out. We've also identified the skin tones, and that's really important here too. So I actually want to boost my oranges probably to like maybe like a plus 18. That looks about good. Do we want to add a little bit of luminance in there? Maybe. All right, and my reds, because I want to create some separation here, I'm going to push the reds like over towards orange, and you can see it's going to do a little bit there in the bricks, and I'm going to desaturate them just a little bit because they are not the most important thing in our photo. These oranges are really. And then for these yellows, I'm gonna shift them over to the orange a bit, give them just a little bit. And you can see what it's doing to our skin tones here, but I give them a little bit more saturation. Let's zoom in to kind of see what it's doing to our skin tones here. All right. Let's back that off, back that off. All right, cool. We like that. We like that. Let's add a little bit of red back in because there's some red undertones in the skins, as you can see what I'm playing with here. And I don't really want to lose those as much as I thought I did before. So Caucasian skin tones usually live in the oranges and reds and a little bit in the yellows. I think if we dial that back a little bit. No, you can kind of see that it's adding a little bit too much magenta to the skin tone. Don't really like that. And then, let's see what these emerald tones again. Like, I don't like messing with people's clothes too much. So we push it over here, push it to the left. That's a lot closer to what it looked like in real life. So that's fine. We're going to keep that. And I do want it to pop just a little bit. And then, cool. This is looking pretty close to done. So what we've done here is essentially isolated three colors that are going to be our primary colors in this palette. And now it kind of depends on what's happening in your photo here. But I personally, even if there's a lot of grass in your scene, I personally would suggest, you know, hitting your greens with, you know, a lot of desaturation and even taking away some of the luminance of them as well. So now that we look at our before and after with our specific colors, there's a lot more contrast going on with them, and we've begun to eliminate details that we don't want and exaggerate details that we do want, which is the whole point of this thing. And so now let's get to like the global color grading, and this used to be called split toning in Classic, but this global color grading wheels, you kind of see them in most video editing programs too. So we're going to go down here to our color grading, and what I want to do is I want to add just a little bit in our mid-tones to our skin tones, because our skin tones are going to be in the shadows in this composition, because most of the information in our histogram up here is in the shadows. So I want to bring them a little bit more orange, and a little bit goes a long way. I try not to bring this ring here outside, like past the middle, when I know that it's going to exaggerate skin tones, because I don't want everyone looking like Oompa Loompas, right? So here's a little before, a little bit after. I want it to be exaggerated, but I don't want it to be insane. And so in the highlights, what I'm gonna do to add a little bit more separation is we can go red, we can go orange, or we can shift it to like a nice like little like yellowy orange, which I like to do. I think that adds just a little bit more to what's in the highlights. It doesn't leave things as like a pure white. It kind of gives the white tones a little bit of a creamish color to them. And then in the shadows, in order to create contrast here, I'm going to add a little bit of cobalt, which is the opposite end of the color spectrum. And so that's going to add contrast in our colors. And I'm going to add that to our shadows. And hopefully we can see here what it's doing is creating a bit of drama in this photo. And I'm actually going to pull it up here a little bit less pure cobalt. All right. And I really like that right there. So here's our before and our after. Before and our after. So you can see there's now the shadows are a lot more cool. And we can push this a little bit if we want to, if you're not happy there. As you can see, I was playing with my blending. So I want them as my subjects to stand out. And so even though those bricks are kind of pretty, I'm going to add probably like a negative 30 and go back just a little bit from there. And so negative 21. Here's what we do for step number 4. Now, if you're editing in a series, as you can see, I have other photos in this series, and I already have the color down kind of where I want it. And so I'm going to hit copy edit settings. And what I'm going to do is not click on our light settings because I want to edit those individually because we were in different scenes. We were adjusting settings on our cameras. So the lighting is going to have to be compensated a little bit. So what I want to do is effectively copy our color. And I want to do the texture, the clarity in our effects. I want to adjust the vignette specifically for each one. The detail and optics are fine. Those are default stuff. High dynamic frame, profile color, that's fine. Just uncheck the light. We don't want to carry the vignette over either. Copy. And so what we've done is essentially already done steps 2 and 3 for this image by pasting. There we go, it on here, and you can see the color's correct already, and it matches our series here. And we can do the same thing over here on this image, the close-up of the hands, right? We've added a lot more warmth to this photo, even though it's a little bit more moody. And in order to create a little bit more mood, all we have to do now is change the exposure a little bit, right? So I'm gonna go here and hit some negative exposure and go highlights. I don't like the highlights up really. What about our whites? We're clipping in the watch there. That's fine. Because it's just in a highlight. Move our blacks down. And then, well, let's see what it looks like without clipping. That's actually fine. I'm okay with that. Another thing that we can do too is we can come in here and add some control points on our curve tool. We could bring up the blacks so they're not actually a pure black anymore. So before, after. They're now intentionally forcing our darkest point to not be a pure black, but to be a gray. And that's, you know, preferentially up to you. The other thing I'm gonna do down here is I think a vignette would actually be really nice because in this photo, the object of our attention is the ring. There we go.
If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe, that would be extremely helpful to the channel. Let me know in the comments below how your pictures came out. Like I said before, I'm genuinely interested in helping you guys.